I'm delighted today to be able to talk to you about a new role in clinical psychology. For the first time, we will be offering an apprenticeship in psychology that will offer a new route that is more accessible and will enable us to bring far more of our communities into the field of clinical psychology. This new role has been developing for more than a year now and is in the final stages, and we will soon be offering apprenticeships in East London for local people with first degrees in psychology to apply to.
When I was a teenager, I was actually quite physically unwell, and I saw a psychologist within the physical health team that I was under, and I remember thinking, that's what I want to do when I'm older. So since then I've kind of been pursuing this as a career, and I think I find the job itself really rewarding, working in mental health settings.
I graduated from uni in, I'll say, 2014, and I felt as if getting into clinical psychology at the time was going to be super difficult because my knowledge of psychology itself wasn't as broad as I wanted it to be. And then I finally got into admin in the secondary care service, which I felt was the most rewarding role for me. And being around different psychologists every day, it was fueling my passion back. I was like, okay, cool, Sabena, now it's time for you to get back into psychology. And then this CAP place came on and it was perfect because of what they're trying to achieve, the accessibility into the BME population. I felt I was perfect for the position and how I would apply it.
And one of the things that's really concerned me and also the kind of senior psychologist in ELFT is that every year we see brilliant potential psychologists try to get into clinical training and then getting, because it's so difficult to get in, that they may give up. And so we recognise that we've lost some really potentially fantastic clinicians to the workforce. And so the CAPS is an opportunity for us to maybe give people another chance, so give people a route to get into psychological professions in a way that is more accessible and more meaningful in terms of how the training progresses.
There are three main drivers for the development of this new role and for building this workforce. The first of these is our recognition that has grown exponentially over the last few years that physical and mental health are intimately entwined and they cannot be separated. To have good physical health, you need to have good mental health and vice versa. So we are understanding now that we have to expand how we support physical health services by providing good psychological health care alongside that. We're also much more aware of the mental health needs of our populations. People feel much more comfortable talking about that, and that also has driven up the need for people to support and provide resources for psychological health and mental well-being. The second main driver is allied to that, and it is about building our workforce. We don't currently have the workforce to meet these growing needs. In order to meet the demands for the mental health implementation plan that was written a couple of years ago, we will need over the next 3 years or so round about 8,000 more workers in the psychological professions, and that includes something like 2,500 psychologists. That's a huge ask, but as well as being a big challenge, this is a fantastic opportunity for us now to build a workforce that is diverse and inclusive. And that brings me on to my third driver. The clinical psychology workforce as it currently stands is mostly middle class, mostly white, mostly female. Despite years of trying to change that demographic so that it better reflects the populations we serve, we've not been successful. And I think that's largely because of socioeconomic reasons. It's immensely expensive to train to be a clinical psychologist. It takes a lot of time, you need to have the resources, you need to have financial stability and backing. That rules out a lot of local people who may have families who live locally and don't have that financial support. The training will be through an apprenticeship. That makes it much more accessible to our local populations. Basically, it means you can train while you're being paid. So for as long as you have a first degree in psychology, you'll be able to apply to be an apprentice. That means to get on a job as an apprentice in one of our organisations, hopefully with us. And you'll learn while you're on the job by attending university. You'll qualify a clinical associate in psychology and be part of the clinical psychology workforce after that. That's how we're hoping to maximally use the assets and the strengths and resources of our local communities in building this new workforce.